Children, today we will study your book, My Communicative English, Class 3, Chapter 11, The Flying Box.
Chapter 11, The Flying Box. First step. Suppose you were on your way to school. An old man met you and said, "If you do not give me any of your books, you will fail in this class." You became really scared. What would you do? Read and follow. A rich old man was living with his son. He said to his son one day, "My son, you'll have all my money after my death. Spend it wisely. But never be idle. You must work hard, earn more money and add to your wealth." Soon after that, the rich old man fell ill and died. The young man, whose name was Ahmed, got all his father's money. "God, it's a lot of money," said Ahmed to himself. He said, "Why should I work? I'll enjoy myself." So young Ahmed did not work at all. He enjoyed himself. Soon he ran out of all his money. He wasted his father's wealth. He became poor. All his friends left him, except for one sincere fellow. This sincere friend gave Ahmed a big wooden box. He said, "Take very good care of this box, Ahmed." Ahmed opened the lid of the box. He felt that it was not an ordinary box. It was a magic box. He sat in it. He said to the box, "Let me see what you can do for me. Take me to the city of Arabia." And the box went flying to the city on Arabia. It came and landed on sand. Ahmed hid the box in the sand and walked into the city. He reached a wonderful palace. A man said to Ahmed, "The king's daughter lives in this palace, but she never meets anyone, and no one can ever meet her." Ahmed went back to the box. He sat in it and said, "Take me to the room of the princess." And soon he was standing in front of the princess. The princess liked him. Ahmed asked her to marry him. "Come here tomorrow," said the princess. Then she added, "My parents will be here. I'm sure they will let you to marry me. Take this gold sword. It is my present to you. With your box, you are wonderful. We will fly different places together." And Ahmed flew away in his magic box. Then again, he got down on the ground, hid the box in a sand and walked into the city with a gold sword. He sold the sword and bought fine clothes for himself. The next day, Ahmed was once again in the room of the princess. The king and the queen were there. They liked him and his wonderful box. They gave Ahmed their consent to marry the princess. "The wedding will take place next week," said the king. He added, "I would like to fly in your box too." The preparation for the wedding began. "Let me buy fireworks for the wedding," Ahmed decided. He bought a lot of squibs and sparkles for the wedding day. He put them all into the box. He took out a firework to try it out. He lighted it. Ah! It fell into the box and exploded. The box was soon turned into ashes. "Alas," Ahmed began to cry, "I can never marry the princess. I'm useless without my magic box. I'll go away from here, work hard somewhere, and make my life a success." And young Ahmed went to another city and began to work hard. Adapted from Anderson. Teacher's note: subject enrichment. Help the student in understanding the idioms. Moral of the story: don't build castle in the air, work hard.